What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel for another GeForce Now News Thursday. We've got a couple of things to talk about this week. A great new feature that I'm excited to announce, plus six games. So let's start with that new feature, and that's going to be 1440p or 1080p, 120 frames per second in browser for both Edge and Chrome. You'll have that option when you go in now to change up and do that, which I think is fantastic to see. I love using the 1440p 120 option on GFN. I do it all the time, and it's great to see that it's going to be supported on browser. So that's a great feature to see come to the service. Now let's move over to our games for this week. So our first game up for the week is a new day and date release for Steam for August 18th, and that's Thymezia. I'm sure I'm getting that wrong, but this is a grueling action RPG with fast-paced combat and an intricate plague weapon system. In a kingdom where death spreads, play as a mysterious character known as the codename Corvus. Prey upon your enemies, wield the power of disease, and find the truth in your own memories. And next up, we have a game called Sensory Age of Ashes, and I don't know where I've been for this game. It has over 13,000 positive reviews, and it's like multiplayer flying around in the air dragons type thing, which is definitely up my alley, so I'm going to be checking this out. It's free to play, so I want to see if it'll run on the Steam Deck. I also want to play it on GFN, and with House of Dragons coming out this weekend, it's kind of smart to have Sensory Ages of Ashes being a dragon game come to the service, so pretty cool. You guys let me know if you've played this game down in the comments below. I completely missed it, but it looks like something that I would normally play or at least check out. So anyways, Sensory Age of Ashes for Steam added to GeForce Now. Our third game up is Clanfolk over on Steam, again with a lot of positive reviews, and this was released in July of this year, so not a new release day and date, but very new recent game. And Clanfolk is a medieval colony sim set in the Scottish Highlands. You harness your environment to survive, fish, gather, hunt, and farm as you prepare for the harsh winter. Build an inn, trade with other clans, have children, and many of them live a life and prosper across the generations. So that's Clanfolk over on GeForce Now. Our fourth game for this week is Coromon. Now this is a game I am somewhat familiar with. It came out this year in March. It's on sale right now in Steam. I'm not sure for how much longer though, so you might want to check that out. But it's typically only about 20 bucks. And Coromon is basically a lot like a Pokemon game. I know it has a lot of positive reviews as well. It's a modern take on the classic monster taming genre. Tame Coromon and explore a vast world filled with thrilling turn-based battles, brain-twisting puzzles, and a mysterious threat to the world awaiting defeat. Nobody said being a battle researcher was easy. So yeah, it might be something that you want to check out there. I know a lot of people do enjoy Coromon here on PC. Now the next title we have is Hypercharge Unboxed. And while this is a 2020 release, this game has been getting a little bit more attention recently, especially with its console releases coming up, and it's actually a pretty fun game. I have played it before, and I do like seeing it come to the service. And this is Hypercharge Unboxed with your childhood dream game. Grab a friend and protect the Hyperscore. Hypercharge is a solo and co-op wave-based first and third-person shooter with a small twist. You're an action figure. Explore, defend, and survive. And maybe it's just me, but when I was a kid growing up, you know, watching the like small soldiers and stuff like that, playing the Army Men games and all of that, it actually is what originally got me to try this game before, and it's pretty fun if you can get a group together for it. I think console release is going to have crossplay, which would help. But yeah, this game, hopefully it continues to do okay and they continue to work on it. I do like seeing it come to GFN. And our final game for this week is the only Epic game we have, and that's Phoenix Point Complete Edition. So with Phoenix Point Complete Edition, the acclaimed strategy game from the creator of XCOM is now available in an Ultimate Collection, including all DLCs, content updates, and product improvements over 4 years of development. And of course, you'll be able to play all that on GeForce Now for Phoenix Point. So that's your six games for this week. And like I said, I know it's not the heavy hitters a lot of you have on your list, and I know there's a ton of games I want to see to come to GeForce Now as well. But I will say that for the most part, this is a decent little list of games to have added to the service. I'm definitely not complaining about getting Hypercharged. Sensory Age of Ashes, I don't know a lot about, but looking at the reviews and the gameplay, I'm really intrigued to go check it out. And we do have that new release over on Steam. We'll see how that game works out and how the reviews go over the next few days. But honestly, like I said, while it doesn't have a lot of the games I know you guys want, I totally get it. I'm not going to completely sneeze at this list either. And one other thing when it comes to the games this week, for my Path of Exile players out there on GFN, the Lake of Calandra DLC is, of course, going to be supported and available on GFN, so I wanted to throw that in there for the news this week. But I gotta say, ultimately, what I really love for this week is the up to 1440p, 120fps on Chrome and Edge. Could definitely open the door to 4K 60 in the future, and I want to continue seeing more parity between the apps and the browser features. Alright guys, thanks a lot for coming to watch. I really appreciate it. If you haven't already, subscribe, thumbs up, ring the bell, leave me your comments down below, and I'll see you in the next one.